Hello, my name is Darren, and I'm president and owner of Big D Broadcast Exchange. And today I'm doing a comparison test between the RCA KU3A and the 77DX and the 44BX. Don't get these in too often. This is one I've repaired for a customer. I put a new ribbon in it, and unfortunately it doesn't have the original shock mount. It has whatever this is, so it could fall out at any minute. I've got my hands here just in case, but it looks pretty sturdy. Anyway, just doing a comparison. I don't get these too often, so I want to hear what it sounds like compared to the 44 and the 77. We're going to run them through the same mixer, same mic preamp, same recorder. Everything is going to be the same at the same time. So this is it, the KU3A RCA ribbon mic that was made out in California, not in New Jersey like all the other ribbon mics. And I'm about 7-8 inches away, talking at a normal level. All right, I'm back again now. This is the RCA 44BX. It has a large ribbon. I just got done putting a new ribbon in this one, so it's about as good as it's ever going to sound. This is the made in the 40s. This is probably a later version because it has the umber brown body with the red meatball. It's a very good sounding mic. It's going to be a little warmer than the KU3A. It's probably not going to have quite the output, but it is a very good warm mic for warming up female vocals or to gnaw off some of the harsh digital sound you get from the modern recording studios. So still being used today in recording studios. It's a very good sounding mic. The front of the mic should sound identical to the rear of the mic. So it's a very good mic to have maybe two singers facing into it, singing together. It should be gnawed off on the side here and more potent right here in the middle. So here it is, the RCA 44BX, and next is the 77. All right, here last we have the 77. I have to make a correction. I might have said a 77DX in my earlier description, but we're actually testing a 77D. But it's pretty much the same thing. These later Ds that had the quarter 28 thumb nuts, that's the larger diameter thumb nut. They also had the MI 4045E on the side of the center band here. Those would be the later ones. They had the same transformers and almost the same magnets as the 77DX. So it's a pretty close comparison. Anyway, this is the 77D. And this is on the bidirectional pattern, a figure eight pattern. And I'm about same distance away with the same recording setup. Again, this is not in a studio environment. It's in my shop. I got my computer fan running in the background. You can probably hear. This is the 77D. Here it is with the pattern changed to directional. This obviously is for if you need the front and the back to sound the same. So let's go to unidirectional. Oh, sorry about the sound. There's non-directional. And there's unidirectional. Shouldn't all the back side of the mic off and have a little different sound characteristic. So this is the unidirectional. That's what makes the 77D and the DX both very desirable mics because you can change the pattern. Make sure it says music, voice one, and voice two. I always just leave it on music. If you don't like the bass, you can roll it off with your mixing board or After Effects. Anyway, this is it, the 77D, the last mic I'm testing.